Hi guys, welcome to Mac Studies. Today we are going to learn introduction of HVAC system and its basic functions. So HVAC, what does it mean? It consists H, V, A and C. H stands for heating, V stands for ventilation, and AC. AC stands for air conditioning. So what is the basic definition of HVAC? It's very simple. HVAC is a system that is able to provide heating, ventilation, and air conditioning based on our requirements. So what is the purpose of the HVAC system? Let's see the purpose of HVAC. First, we will look the purpose of H, that is the heating. Look at this scenario. It's very chilled weather. All around there is a snowfall. What do you think? You need to cool or heat. If you visit US or Canada or Finland, or there are many other countries, the temperature is very low and it is very difficult to survive if you don't have enough precautions for that. In US, the temperature goes 0.3 to minus 16.3 degrees centigrade, and Canada it is around minus 15 to minus 14 degrees centigrade, and Finland it is minus 30 to minus 20 degrees centigrade. This temperature is illustrated here for reference only, and human beings are comfortable with 23 to 24 degrees centigrade. So what do you think? This temperature in US, Canada and Finland, it is very low. So we have to be comfortable and we have to make the temperature like 23-24. So there are so many devices or equipments are available for heating, like gas furnace, heat pump, boiler, space heaters, electric heaters. There are so many type of equipments are available. For example, this is a room and the room is having minus 10 degree centigrade temperature. So we have to put some amount of heat within this room to make temperature 23 or 24 degrees centigrade so that room temperature will be acceptable to us. So we can define heating process. Heating is a process by which it can heat the area which is to be conditioned. Now what do you think about India or the Gulf country where the summer temperature is high? So what do you think, heating is required? If you study the winter conditions in different regions, you will get a clear view. In Kolkata, its winter temperature goes to 12-13 degrees centigrade. In Delhi, it goes to 7-8 degrees centigrade. Mumbai, 16-17 degrees centigrade. In a Gulf country like Oman, winter temperature goes to 11-12 degrees centigrade. To maintain comfortable temperature like 23-24, definitely there should be some heating system. So here also heating is required. Normally by electric heaters, heating condition is maintained. If the temperature is very low, like Delhi, many places people use room heaters as well. So within this HVAC, let's learn V, that is ventilations. Let's learn the basic of ventilation system. Suppose you are working in an office which is enclosed and there are so many people. We take oxygen and we release carbon dioxide. So over the period of time, concentration of carbon dioxide will increase and the concentration of oxygen will decrease, which will create health hazard or headache for people. So what we have to do? We have to provide additional oxygen, or we have to remove the carbon dioxide or odor which is created within this office. So this is a room. And over the period of time, the carbon dioxide concentration or odor is increased. And here is the fresh air supply, which provides oxygen. And this is the exhaust air. So with these continuous circulations, concentration of oxygen will increase and carbon dioxide concentration will decrease. So ventilation system means the process of changing or replacing air in a space. It is used to remove carbon dioxide, odors, and replace it with fresh air.
There are so many ventilation equipment for the ventilation system.
So we have learned HV. So what about AC, that is air conditioning? So what is air conditioning? Air conditioning is a process by which we can condition the air by cooling, heating, freshens, circulation of air, and control its moisture content. This is an equipment. Here conditioned air is entering, and within some process within this equipment, conditioned air is coming out. So this is basically the air conditioning equipment or air conditioning system. So what does unconditioned air mean? Unconditioned air means the air which is not conditioned. That means the air may be very hot or may be very cold, very high humid or very dry or polluted. Basically, it's not healthy air and its quality is not good for the people, things or equipment. Based on the atmospheric conditions, pollutions, it is required to change the unconditioned air into conditioned air.
There are so many air conditioning equipment for the air conditioning system.
Air conditioning system helps to change the unconditioned air into conditioned air. Now, what does conditioned air mean? It means cooling. In extremely hot weather or wherever heat is generated, need to cool. It may be required for people or things or equipment. Atmosphere has different temperature in different places. If you visit any Gulf country, you will see the outside temperature is very high in the summer condition. So there are large buildings. So cooling is essential to be comfortable or to live there. An air conditioning system helps to reduce the outside temperature into comfortable temperature. Now look at this scenario. Here's a very chilled weather. What do you think? Is cooling required here? Let's try to understand. So this is a room in that weather. So definitely cooling is not required as the outside temperature is very low. Now if you put an equipment here and the equipment generates heat, the room will gradually be heated and the temperature will rise. And without cooling, the temperature will gradually increase, which may harm the equipment. So cooling has to be provided for this equipment or the rooms. Now heating. We have already learned in the cold region, to make us comfortable, heating system has to be provided. In many of the air conditioning system, apart from the cooling, a separate heating arrangement is provided to heat the air whenever it is required. Now in a hot summer, when the outside temperature is very high, do you think heating is required? Let's try to understand. This is the air. However, if you visit any coastal area, you will see the air consists moisture. Normally, we are comfortable with 40 to 60% relative humidity. But in coastal area, if you visit, you will see there's a huge moisture content. Although the outside temperature is high, the moisture content is more. So we have to remove this moisture content from the room. Otherwise, it will harm us as well as our equipment too. So heating system should be there to remove the moisture from the air into an acceptable limit. So with the heating, we can remove this moisture content. Now humidifying. If the air is very dry, then the moisture content will be very less and we feel uncomfortable. To make us comfortable, we have to inject some moisture into the air. And this process is simply humidifying. And dehumidifying, this is also a process of removing moisture content from the air. If the moisture content is very high, a separate dehumidifier is required to remove the moisture from the air. Filtration. The air which we take into the system may contain various dust particles, other unacceptable foreign particles, which needs to be removed from the air. There are a series of filters are used in air conditioning system for the filtration of air, circulation of air. This is a building and it consists various rooms. How to circulate air from one system? So there should have a process of air circulation to each room. Ducting systems are used for the circulation of air into the rooms or into the conditioned areas. In small air conditioning system, ducting is not required as each room will have air conditioners. Pressurization. Outside atmosphere contains dust particles or other foreign particles. If we slightly overpressure our buildings or conditioned areas, then definitely outside dust particles will not be infiltrated within the buildings. So slightly overpressure will help to protect the building from the dust particles. So this process or the pressurization can be done by air conditioning system as well. So we can do a lot of things with HVAC system like cooling, heating, humidifying, dehumidifying, control moisture content, clean, freshen, and circulation of air. There are various HVAC equipment which can do all or the combination of things. Thank you so much. Please visit mixstudies.com.